on stage, I rock out. Every day money can't break, no timeouts. Change them quick, they sign up. Tryna hear my line now. Licking up, come find out. 1v1, you dust like a whiteout. Studio been my hideout. Can't shed tears, mama, ain't no cry now. On me, gonna blind out. Get in the team, gotta pass your tryouts. Yeah, yeah. Booming this like Metro. Groupies on me, that's fine, don't sweat those. Been on keeping my head strong. My dog ain't talk about Petco. Brand new ones, they retros. Live fast, die on set, my headstone. Stop been grown. You ain't get money, been frank in the friend zone. Got, I ain't never switched up in the family. Be talking to that at me. Gotta watch my wrist, that's classy. I'm a dog to a she nasty. Send him about me. My mama proud she had me. Can't let nobody surpass me. I move to the back like an athlete. Got a little buzz, but these zippers don't chance me. Just take a look at my rap sheet. Independent, many so can't stand me. Won't stop till I got me a Grammy. A crib with a leg and a whip for my granny. I ain't never had me, no plan B. Look at me now, got a problem, get at me.
Never leave the house without the pack. Where my at? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up.
I ain't got a but they hands to the ceiling. I ain't palm reading, but I got them in they feelings, yeah. Ain't vanilla ice, but I'm iced out chilling. Was the good guy till they made me the villain. Was gonna get a room, but they gave me a villa. I got game sports center. 20 bands for the dinner. 20 dips in a sprinter. What's a two up. Never been afraid to play my cards. What's a risk to a winner? Barely hang out with these days. What's a lame to a real one? Never leave the house without the pack. Where my at? Take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
Hype me up.
Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up.
It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Today on to week 15 in the NFL, and we've got a good matchup in store, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Atlanta Falcons. Set to go, Younghoe Koo ready to do the honors. And this one is underway here on EA Sports. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Begin on the ground with Gainwell. There he goes, right side. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 31 yards there and a first down. Another good run there. He's been good all season long. I don't know if he's going to win that MVP award, but just to be in the discussion, obviously that means he's had a great run.
The raw numbers put him in the discussion. Can he carry his team to enough victories? Can he put them in a spot where we say to ourselves, well, an MVP carries his team to the playoffs. That's what he's going to need in order to get that award.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
You talk about this Falcon defense.
They come in a top 10 unit against the pass, currently eighth in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move it to the top five.
After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. Two-yard gain.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Sack. Well, they changed that quickly.
But did they ever? And it was something they talked about with us extensively. They needed to get pressure. How were they going to get to the quarterback? Obviously, they schemed themselves into a great play, didn't they?
An 8-yard return there after a punt of 47. And the Falcons will get it first and 10 from deep in their own territory. Falcons first and 10 here as Ritter gets them ready at their own 14-yard line. Now a first carry here for Robinson. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Ritter will set up to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, his first throw of the game. Going to be intercepted. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
So problems with errant passing continuing. Remember, he threw two picks in the loss last week and now another here in this first quarter.
And sometimes, partner, this is the result of a quarterback who's simply trying to do too much. Feels like he's trying to make up for what he did last week. And you can't do it all on one throw.
Quick pass out to Miller. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
That'll give him eight that time, and that'll bring up a second down and just a couple. That was a lightning-fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately, so he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
And they get to him quickly as he stopped right around the 13. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here comes third and the length of the football. They'll try and run for it with Gainwell. Trying to barrel up in there, but I don't think he got it. This defense not budging. Back-to-back carries of just 2 yards.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on third and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Lynch. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
Well, how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves, maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
So from their own end zone here, this kicks away. Taken on the midfield logo. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. We call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here first and 10. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Cooks motions to the left. On first and 10, it's Gainwell. And he powers through the first lane, but he's going to be swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. We talked about this Falcon defense. And they come in a top 10 unit against the pass, currently eighth in the NFL.
This secondary has really developed into one of the strengths of this team. They diagnose, they cover, they run, they hit. What a nice team.
This one taken in by Olave. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
First down, Saints.
And now Lynch. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Now a second and 10. They'll bring a tight end in motion right. Once again, it's Lynch. Flush to his right. That's to his running back, Gainwell. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
That's a big league job there, getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
Here we go now on first and goal. In motion left goes Cooks. They'll run here with Gainwell. And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. Scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Again, it'll be Gainwell. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kenneth Gainwell with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Saints post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game.
Falcons nothing.
The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team booms it away. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
Here's second and 10. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. So here's a third and 14.
Tackle made at the 17-yard line.
17.
Looking to throw it here, Ritter. Hard throw, incomplete.
Not many boos just yet from this home crowd, but they may be starting soon as I'm starting to detect an uneasy murmur through this crowd. This offense, they've been lifeless in this first half. And now here's another punting situation and a fourth down.
On the double.
And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14. They're going for this. Here's Ritter. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with a football. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. They run behind center with Gainwell. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A.J. Terrell coming up to make the play.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Second and five. And motion left goes a tight end. They go play action with Lynch. They'll roll him out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
And here he's down in the red zone. You need to be smart and not force anything. So that's a wise decision to just get rid of the football.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. Off the play fake. Here's Lynch. Out to his left. And he's able to get this down to the five-yard line before he's out of bounds. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. Now they send a man in motion right. And now they'll shift things around. From the gun, here's a run by Gainwell. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the six inside the five to the four.
You know, when this offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow. And this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Gainwell again. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kenneth Gainwell. That's his 19th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Saints have taken a two-touchdown lead now. Extra point up and through. And that'll make the score 14-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. From the 25, here's second and six. Going play action, Ritter. And incomplete on the deep ball.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
4 minutes to play here in quarter number two. Ritter throwing on third down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play, second down. Ritter now. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. So given 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and now that sets up third and two. Robinson will try to pick it up. And they nearly sprung in that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to throw, Ritter. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Ritter, he wants to change the play here. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Thing falling apart now. Another one intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And the Saints are going to take over here up near the 40.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. You know, in our research packet this week, prepping for the game, so many articles. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Now for the point after. And that one makes it 14-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Now a second and six. Toss left side, Gainwell. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 65 yards rushing for him in this one as he starts to draw nearer to a 1,500-yard campaign. They go play action now. Lynch, he'll buy some time right. He's got right on the short throw. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now second down.
Well, these two teams, they met in New Orleans earlier in the year with the Saints coming out on top. So a win here in Atlanta would give them the season sweep.
They'll come up second and 7. This time, they'll just keep this on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it. it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Here's third and three. Here's Lynch. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. From the gun, a give to Gainwell. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final play of the half, it's Lynch. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. And now look at this, big game, but a fumble. And this one will actually go out of bounds, so no recovery. And that is how we can end this first half. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Saints out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. A one-touchdown ball game, 14-7. Our scores, we get back at it on EA Sports. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
At their own 15-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Well, this is intercepted. They get Ritter for the third time. Picked by Julian Love. His guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
Well, I certainly think that we're seeing a big reason why this team has struggled to put points on the board so far, because too many of their drives have ended in turnovers already, and we still have almost a full half of football yet to play.
After the interception, here's Lynch sliding out of the pocket. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
I did like his decision-making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down. And don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
to something else. Straight ahead, it's Gamewell. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of six as he gets halfway to the goal line. Play action. Now Lynch. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Troy Anderson applying the pressure and picking up the sack. You can almost see his eyes light up defensively. As a linebacker, that's about as quick as you can get to a quarterback.
So what did your third grade teacher teach you about straight lines, right? As soon as you have those, you take full advantage of them. He found a gap in the offensive line, got to the quarterback, and put him on the deck.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. On third down, it's Gamewell. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. He's just short. He got 6 of the 7 he needed, so that leaves a decision here on fourth and a yard. Out now is the field goal unit for New Orleans. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And his kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
Here's 2nd and 7. Here's Lance. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Throwing his Lance on 3rd down. And that would be incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the 3rd quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers, both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. And they'll go for it. Lance. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. On first and 10, it's Robinson. And he'll work down inside the 45. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. False start's going to push him back, but these days, how hard must it be to be an offensive lineman?
It's very hard, Brandon. You've got defensive linemen flinching, trying to draw you offside. You've got the loud crowds, and there are just so many super athletic players on defense now that you have to deal with each week. But through it all, these guys just sit in there for four quarters and slug it out.
On second down, another shot for Robinson. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43. And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Now Lance. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Saints will have solid field position here as they take over at the 45-yard line. So that now two consecutive drives that have ended in interceptions. You wonder if he's trying to do a little too much out there.
Oh, I like where you're going with that, that maybe he's pressing it a little bit, trying to be too fine with his throws, or maybe overestimating his arm. It could be a combination of all of those things. In any event,
taking it right down Broadway. There he goes again. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kenneth Gainwell, 55 yards. And the Saints are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
At their own 18-yard line.
Bring it home, boys. We got this.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Excellent work there by Lance as he scrambles for the first down.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there because, to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Lance looking to throw it. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Ritter. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Ritter going to change it up. Out of the gun now on third down. And that is incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Julian Love picks it, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanketed the field going all the way back to the opening drive, and they come up with a pick right there.
Brings up second and 12 at the 32-yard line.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Throwing, Lynch, setting up the screen with Gainwell. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
The Saints on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 8. Now it's Lynch. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further.
Well, ultimately not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the 3 and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clipped him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead. In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard, but that is not the case as we play on here this fourth quarter.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw, it's Lance. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down, Lance. Oh, and this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Again, they'll throw it with Lance. That to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Throwing now is Lance. Eluding the pressure right.
And he's going to go out of bounds. Gigantic loss. Kept retreating. Steps out. That goes down as a sack and a big loss of yardage.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Looking deep here for Mooney.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Cooks motions to the left. On the handoff, Gainwell
able to fight through one tackle. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
And even 150 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Now they'll change things around before the snap. Gainwell will score. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Touchdown, New Orleans.
The try here for the extra point. He's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
On the return from his end zone is Grant. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
They're on the 17-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Looking to throw it here, Ritter.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire.
You know I'ma spin it. I don't go back and forth like it's tennis. I'm in mode, I've been locked on a mission. Cupid G, I ask God as my witness. I'm not pressing my bro off suspicion. Never pressing my bro off suspicion. She from Nola, she got superstition. I'm not waiting and hoping and wishing. I'm not stopping, I'm balling relentless. I'm a stepper, I'm standing on business. And the rumors, I'm minding my business. I'm a tutor, teach you how to get it. I tap in with the ones in your city. We make movies, we all the way with it.
Point them out, 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 watch them panic. Got two chains on, I'm too late. Got one watch on my wrist. I'm round, round and I'm getting it. I'm young, but I ain't ignorant. They keep asking who the hell you think you are. Him, 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 him and him. They keep asking who the hell you think you is. Him, 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 him and him.
I told the people, yes, I'm him. I did the impossible, but I'm not Kim. Gotta be by the escalator. I'm on the rim. Hit the butter with a blitz. We gon' study this film. I ain't gotta say nothing. Ain't always for real. Country, but trying to give me your meal. You want you some problems. You got you a deal. Mr. Bushwick, bitch, tell me how you feel. No, I'm not from Dallas, but yes, I'm a cowboy. We them boys. We making loud noise. Staying fresh today. I be looking like a house. Got a defense on line that'll make them sit down. Boy, like a D-lineman, but still making touchdowns. Beat them in their hometown. I ain't here now one time. I've been a big bully since I was on the playground. Now I'm all grown up and I still don't play right on.
Point them out, point them out, point them out. Point them out, point them out, point them out, point them out, watch them panic. Got two chains on, I'm too late. Got one watch on my wrist. I'm round, round and I'm getting it. I'm young, but I ain't ignorant. They keep asking who the hell you think you are. Him, 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 him and him. They keep asking who the hell you think you is. Him, 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 him and him.
Real.
Incredibly, I do this competitively, ineditably. These falling silent when I walk up in the building. Worry about their future like I'm here to snatch their children. That line was brilliant. How I'm not already in the millions? Am I not the picture of resilience? Why they test my patience? Hyping all this lame. No one got a brain, they just be liking all the same. Is this what the I'm in on industry games? I'm convinced that nobody is speaking my language. I'ma get it as so listen close when I say this. After every feel stainless. I can make a fiend go, go. Everything I wrote gon' smoke so dangerous. I can make an Einstein feel brainless. But look on the bright side, hope yield changes. I'ma get it started, please give me a pardon. Cause this the type of beat that get the whole crowd marching. Time to shut it down, we made the whole town Spartan. I'm from outer space, so all my homegirls marching. It's about to get critical, this moment is pivotal. Here to feed the streets that say my influence umbilical. We gon' make it grimy, devil get behind me. Told you I'm the best, I done said it with my chest. So for real, nobody try me.
Down in the new town, I already feel that it's eyes on me. I'm getting looked up down with the big crowd. They already gone by the size of me. I don't really give a fuck. Put my goose up, I will not live in apology. I wish you lose love, but truly you suck. Homemade way for a prodigy.
And I say, one for the money and two for the love. We the new era, so whoever may feel they above. Live in delusion, that's an illusion, it's absent. Keep it together, don't act like you didn't know what it was. I'm on a whole nother planet, I'm about to show you. This wouldn't work if we planned it, meaning you won't understand it. We have to ring like a Saturn, this feel like splitting an atom. We got involved with the pattern, so now we up and we at them. Watch out for my evolution, around and start a revolution. I am more than a being, I'm an institution. If I gotta reiterate, I swear I'ma lose it. It's my world and I'm generous and that job peruse it. How obnoxious, she ain't got a conscience. She's okay with being a little absurd and pompous. That's because I kill it, then stick around just to haunt it. Waiting on my thank you, be grateful that I would even let you watch it.
Just down in the new town, I already feel that it's eyes on me. I'm getting looked up down with the big crowd, they already thrown by the size of me. I don't really give a fuck, put my deuce up, I will not live in apology. I wish you lose love, but truly you suck, don't make way for a prodigy.
Gonna catch your breath for a second, look at your neighbor and check him. We bout to march, so if you not get to step in. I done told you who I am, I'm a force to be reckoned with. I think just be mad because my voice is so decadent. I'm setting the precedent, no mistakes and no accident. We ignoring the standard set because our lowest is passing it. This alone is a classic hit, I'm a verb amongst adjectives. If the industry full of
and my words is a laxative. I'm a maniac on these beats, I'm insane, and it's not discreet. I'm enraged because y'all ain't see it. I'm spraying.